What's good, YouTube? It's your boy YPD Walls back with some more NBA 2K20 content for you. And I know a lot of the videos of the Ronnie 2K and Shakedown has surfaced. They talked about Park. They talked about Jordan Rec Center. They talked about the My Career Builder. They talked about Community Day. They talked about the demo. Man, they talked about a whole bunch of everything. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to go ahead and pick out a couple topics to discuss in this gameplay. The first topic I'm going to discuss is new features being added to the Jordan Rec Center. Ronnie didn't really go into a lot of details about what's going to be added into the Jordan Rec Center, but he said people are going to be happy. You know, this year in 2K19, the Jordan Rec Center, you didn't get to wear your own clothes. Because I remember back in the day, was it 2K15, something like of that nature. I didn't have 2K15, but I've actually looked at a lot of videos of Jordan Rec Center, and I've seen that you can wear your own clothes. So maybe they're going to add that feature back into it. Maybe they're going to add the feature to where it's like a stage type feature to where you can actually walk in and you can hop on the dots and play with whoever you want to be played with instead of being matched up all weird. Because you know, this year that matched people up so weird. Like you may bring I take my pure sharp and then I got all shooters. And next thing you know, I'm at the three guarding a 6'10 person or a 7 foot power forward at the three. Well, my guy's 6'5. So either if they don't allow us to actually match up and if they don't allow us to actually get on the dots, hopefully their matchmaking system is great. You know what I mean? Like, I know if you were going in with a team of five, if somebody else is going in with a team of five, you get matched up. It is what it is. But if you're going in solo with, you know, and you're joining a crew, they should at least put you in the position that you're playing. I know there's probably more shooting guards and point guards and small forwards. You know, I know there's probably more small forwards and, I mean, there's more probably centers and probably power forwards than there are shooting small fours or something like of that nature. But I just think they need to match stuff up a lot better. But as you can see, you know, I'm hitting my excellent. Well, I wasn't excellent on the free throw thing, but shout out to the person who won this thing, because you get I did this and I got like 100 or 200 something. The personal leaderboard had like 1,000, so I don't know. You know what I'm saying? They had it down pat. But anyway, I just think that I'm looking forward to the added features, you know, the added additions to the rec center. I don't know what it's going to be. We don't know what it's going to be. We may see something because, you know, the trailer, the neighborhood trailer is dropping later on at the end of August, probably like a week before the game drops or maybe week and a half before NBA 2K20 actually drops. So we get a general idea from there because, you know, they're going to throw little snippets and clips of different things into that so we can see it, you know, so we can see different aspects of the neighborhood and stuff like that. Another thing I want to touch on is the complexity, because it seems like they're going away from archetypes and allowing you to create superstars, defensive superstars, stuff of that nature. So they're allowing you to basically create a player instead of create an archetype. You know what I'm saying? Because let's be realistic, archetypes cool, but archetype, you're limited. You know, dual archetypes is cool, but dual archetypes, you're still limited, but some people can force the issue. Like, you know, you see lockdowns that can hit green threes, blast cleaners that can hit green threes. But I guess this My Player Builder, you're actually building a player how you want them. Now, this is just speculation, me throwing it out there, because it seems like it's very complex, and the way it's being explained from Ronnie 2K and the way it's being explained from a lot of the devs and a lot of the people at 2K, it seems like you're gonna have the ability to actually make what you want to make instead of being, you know, we're kind of forced into like, okay, do I want a defender sharp? Do I want a pure this? Do I want a rim sharpshooter? Do I want, you know what I mean? You want more attributes. As a rim sharpshooter, if I had a, for example, I'm just throwing this out. If I wanted to play defense at the rim and I wanted to dunk on somebody and shoot a little bit, why can't I build a person that can do that? You see what I'm saying? So I think they may just give us the ability to actually build that type of player that we actually want to play with. And the reason why they're releasing the demo and allowing us to do this and allowing us to go above an 85 on the demo, I'm not saying that the rep on the demo is going to be the same as on the game, as far as, because we may be able to, y'all never know, we may be able to rep up to a 99 on the demo. It may be that easy just to rep your player up to a 99 and get his badges and just play with him and see how everything feels. Because I think they're going to let us play a lot of my career on this demo. You know, so I believe we're gonna be able to play certain parts, and there's going to be a couple parts we can go to. I think it's going to be set up like NBA Live. It's going to be set up like NBA Live 18 demo. And if you don't know what I mean, I stress this in my past two or three videos. Go download the NBA Live 18 demo. See if they still have the demo out, or even if they got NBA Live, it probably should be like $1 or something like that, or if it's, you know, or for free at this point. But check out NBA Live, man. And I'm thinking the demo is going to be something of that nature. So they're going to allow us to play. And the reason why they're doing it is because they're going to allow us to want to play the game. Because when we play the prelude, or whatever you want to call it, we make a build, but we really don't get to feel the build, because the build's like a 60 overall, and then you may rep them out, and then you may max them out to an 85. And you're like, oh fuck. Or excuse my language, but you may be, oh man, it's not what I want to make. I don't like how this build handles. I don't like how he dribbles. I don't like how he shoots. He's too slow. He may say stuff like that. But with the demo, it's going to be a lot. You're going to be able to, okay, so when I get this player to a 97, he's going to feel like this. Or when I get this player to this, it's going to feel like this is the build I'm making. You know what I'm saying? So I just feel like this My Career Builder, there's going to be a lot of positives to this My Career Builder. And there's going to be a lot of negatives. So, I mean, I don't know what it's going to allow us to do. But if this My Career Builder, I say My Career Builder. I keep saying My Career Builder. My Player Builder. If this My Player Builder allows us to make 7'3 big men that can dribble, there's going to be a lot of cheese in the game. So, I mean, we know it's 2K. People exploit 2K every year. People are always going to figure out how to exploit the game. So don't be surprised if you go up against a 7'3 pure playmaker that can shoot. You know what I'm saying? Like, hey, you know, it is what it is. But hopefully 2K limits a lot of hopefully 2K limits a lot of the attribute caps, as far as like there shouldn't be no 7'3 speed boost or nothing. You know, there shouldn't be no pure stretch, hopping from side to side. And no, there shouldn't be none of that. You know, there shouldn't be a big man. There shouldn't be a big man the size of Anthony Davis doing step backs, snatch backs, James Harden, quick. Now, I'm not saying they can't do that. I'm just saying they shouldn't be doing it very swiftly and quick like they a Steph Curry or a James Harden or a Chris Paul or Kyrie. You know what I'm saying? Like, so. So that's where the complexity comes in with this new My Player Builder system. But like me, honestly, I'm excited because in my head, I already know the builds that I want to make. I already know what type of build I want. Me just being a pure sharp, those days are really over with, unless it's archetype or nothing else. But other than that, I will make a video. I'll make sure to make videos of good builds and stuff like that to make. I know a lot of people gonna want the cheese build, so I'm gonna find the cheesiest builds. A little bit of dribbling, a little bit of shooting, a little bit of defense, and a little bit of rebounding. I'm gonna find those builds and a little bit of dunking. You know what I'm saying? People like them contact dunks and stuff like that. But like always, leave your feedback in the comment section below. I love the comments. I love to chat it up with y'all. Y'all know how I get down. You can look at all my videos. If you just respond to anything, I always respond. I love communicating with y'all. If you ain't got the noties on, put the noties on. Even though they broke at times, put them on. Smash that like button. Smash that sub button. And I'm out.